When I became a campus pastor at the church where I'm currently on staff, one of the very first leadership principles they taught me was rights and responsibilities. That concept stuck with me because it's a very biblical and Jesus-like model of leadership. And that's what I want to talk to you about in this Drive Time video. Let's get started. Welcome to Equipped. I'm Mario Escobedo. On this channel, I do a lot of Bible study type videos, but I also do videos like this one in which I provide reflections and insight on pastoral ministry. No matter what kind of video I'm doing, I'm always doing it with the intention of equipping you to minister effectively to those God has placed under your care. So if that sounds helpful to you, then consider subscribing to this channel, tapping the notification bell so that you're always up to date on the latest teachings. The concept of rights and responsibilities was popularized, as far as I know, by John Maxwell in his book, Developing the Leader Within You. There's a link to that book in the description of this video in case you want to get your little hands on it. There are several premises that underlie this principle of rights and responsibilities, and one of them is that there is a general misconception or misunderstanding when it comes to leadership. That misunderstanding is this: the higher you go in leadership, the more rights you should have. Now, right off the bat, you can tell that that misconception goes against what Jesus taught, because he said that whoever wants to be first needs to be last, and he taught by example that he came to serve rather than to be served. Give me just a second. Just 2 sweet tea refills, please. My wife and my daughter love sweet tea from Bill Miller. To illustrate the concept of rights and responsibilities, Maxwell uses 2 triangles placed side by side. Beneath the 2 triangles is the word rights, and above the 2 triangles is the word responsibilities. Let's deal first with the triangle that's on the left. That triangle represents a person who is a non-leader in your church, has no leadership responsibilities or no leadership role in your church. You'll notice that the wide side of the triangle is at the bottom where it says rights. What this means is that this person, the non-leader, has a lot of rights in your church. They have a lot of rights. You'll notice that the top end of the triangle, or the narrow end of the triangle, is on the side where it says responsibilities, meaning that that same person has little, if any, responsibilities whatsoever. The triangle that's on the right represents a leader in your church, or this could even represent you. And you'll notice that the narrow side of the triangle is on the side of rights. What this means is that leader has very few rights. The wide side of the triangle is on the side of responsibilities, meaning, of course, that that person has a lot of responsibilities. The general premise of rights and responsibilities is this: the higher you go in leadership, the fewer rights you have and the more responsibilities you assume. Now again, notice how there's a misconception in current models of leadership, which think that the higher you go in leadership, the more rights you should have and the fewer responsibilities you should have. For example, there's a phrase that I've been hearing a lot in the political sphere, and it's, nobody is above the law. I think what people are trying to say here is that as people ascend in their leadership, they reach a certain level where they think that the rules and the laws don't apply to them. You'll notice how that's rights and responsibilities in action. They feel that as they've gone up in leadership, they have fewer responsibilities and more rights. Again, that's incorrect. Now, let me give you some practical examples of how rights and responsibilities can play out in your church. Let's say there's a person who attends your church occasionally, a non-leader, the occasional congregant. Well, this person has a lot of rights and very few responsibilities. What are some of the rights? And I'm going to use rights in air quotes. What are some of the rights this person has? Well, on any given Sunday, they can wake up and say, you know, I just don't feel like going to church today. And because they're not accountable to anybody, they don't have any leadership roles or responsibilities, they exert no influence over anybody, well, they have that right to say, I'm not going to church today, and they just skip church. That person also has the right to say, you know, I don't feel like tithing this month or this week. And because, again, they don't have a leadership responsibility, they're not accountable to anybody, they don't have any influence over anybody, they have that right and they exert that right. They have a lot of rights and very few responsibilities. That same person can decide that they're going to blow up at their wife or blow up at their kids in public, and I don't care who sees me, I can do whatever I want. They have that right because they have no leadership responsibilities in your church. But take those same scenarios and apply them to you as the pastor or to a top leader in your church. You can't get up on a given Sunday and say, I don't feel like going to church today. As the pastor, you lost that right to say, I'm not going to church today, and you now have that responsibility to show up every Sunday at church. As the pastor, you also lost the right to say, I'm not going to tithe. Well, no, we lead by example, and so we have the responsibility to tithe. We lost the right not to tithe. Similarly, I can't be out in public just berating my wife and yelling at my daughter just because I feel I can. I lost the right to do that. Now, not that I would do that anyway. I lost the right to do that because I have a leadership role, leadership responsibilities, and I have influence over people at my church. Imagine how things would look if that was my attitude in public. It doesn't work. I lost that right, and I now have taken on, I've assumed many more responsibilities. As a ministry team, we try our best to instill this concept of rights and responsibilities in our people. But you know as well as I do that this has to be modeled. You can teach something till you're blue in the face, but unless your people see it modeled, it's never really going to take hold. Now, we do this not because John Maxwell wrote about it, but because this is really the leadership philosophy that Jesus instituted. Remember what Jesus said in Matthew chapter 20, verses 25 through 28. He said, "You know that the rulers of the Gentiles lorded over them, and their high officials exercise authority over them. Not so with you. Instead, whoever wants to become great among you must be your servant, and whoever wants to be first must be your slave. Just as the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many." That verse leaves it absolutely clear, at least for me, that the higher you go in leadership, the fewer rights you have and the more responsibilities you assume. I'd encourage you to learn more about this concept of rights and responsibilities, and you can do so by picking up John Maxwell's book, and again, there's a link to that book in the description of this video. Now, let me ask you a question. What's one essential leadership principle that you share with your church? Let me and the others watching this video know in the comments below, because remember, some of the best ideas and insights come from you, the community of the Equipped. That's it for now, and I pray that with regards to the concept of rights and responsibilities, you feel just a little bit more equipped. God bless, and I'll see you next time.